So year seven, a very warm welcome to the family of All Saints. One of our traditions is to have our annual service of welcome. And I'm so pleased that we can continue with that tradition this year in whatever our new normal happens to be. You're now part of our family and part of the wider All Saints community. And in that way, you'll need to fulfill your ambitions and exceed your expectations and grow together in respect, resilience, community, family, excellence in our faith in the love that Jesus Christ has for us. So I'll always ask this question: are you ready to be inspired, be excellent and succeed? And I know you're ready.
And we will start our welcome liturgy with the sign of the cross. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Loving God, inspire us to be excellent in everything we do in All Saints. Help us to love one another and respect all members of our community. Enable us to use our gifts and talents to the best of our ability so that we succeed on our chosen path. Amen.
Hello Year 7, my name is Maddock and I'm head boy at All Saints Catholic College.
Hello Year 7, my name is Izzy and I'm head girl at All Saints Catholic College.
We are pleased to welcome you formally to our school and we hope that you've settled in well so far. Although our welcome service is usually in person, we would like to take this opportunity to say that we are always here for you, especially at this time.
As a school we've changed significantly throughout the years, from what's been called inadequate to now being one of the best schools in the area. Our vague memories of Year 7 includes ones of change and community as we push forward our new ethos, be inspired, be excellent and succeed. In those challenging times, we came together in unity to work through them and achieve the outstanding results you will now benefit from.
It seems as though we're living in a time of uncertainty, where the news is just full of doom and gloom. But in actual fact, things aren't as bad as everyone says they are. Things at the moment may seem scary and difficult, but with the help of our amazing staff, pupils and community, we'll be able to overcome this with a smile on our face.
We promise to support everyone. As it says in Isaiah, when you go through deep waters, I will be with you. Hope will lead us to overcome these rough seas with our faith growing and family stronger than ever. Today we turn to the Lord in prayer as we ask for determination, resilience and strength.
Seven Romero welcomes you to our liturgy. At All Saints, we are all joined together in faith.
Seven Assisi welcomes you to our liturgy. At All Saints, we are all joined together as a family.
Seven Kobe welcomes you to our liturgy. At All Saints, we are all joined together in our resilience.
7 John Paul welcomes you to our liturgy. At All Saints, we are all joined in our excellence.
7 Teresa welcomes you to our liturgy. At All Saints, we are all joined together as a community.
7 Ward welcomes you to our liturgy. At All Saints, we are all joined together in our respect.
For the times we are not welcoming to others and being selfish, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
For the times we got others in trouble or blamed others, Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
For the times we didn't listen and respect our parents, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. Do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you, because you are precious in my sight and honoured, and I love you. Do not fear, for I am with you. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Good afternoon, everybody, or good morning, if the case may be. I've been invited to by the college to read the gospel which we have chosen for today's reflection, and is taken from St. Matthew's Gospel, chapter 22, verses 34 to 40. When the Pharisees heard that he had silenced the Sadducees, they gathered together, and one of them, a lawyer, asked him to test him. Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest? He said to him, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind. This is the greatest and first commandment. And the second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophet. Now, we're assembled here in St. Mary's Catholic Church, Dockingfield, where I'm the parish priest, and my name is Father Oliver O'Doherty, and I want to reflect upon that with you for a few minutes, and hopefully you'll find it spiritually helpful or supportive in your journey of life. When we decide to buy a birthday card or a greetings card, we usually have some idea of what the contents of that card should be. One of these words is, needless to say, love. Many of us enjoy songs that speak about love. All you need is love, according to the Beatles. If you pick up a hymn book, for instance, in school or in the local church, significant number of hymns speak about love. I give you a new commandment, love one another as I have loved you. Love is his word. Your love is greater. People too love their football team. People love golf, their swimming, their school, their parish. And following the Manchester Arena bombing, we had signs on our buses, our cars, and the windows of our homes saying, I love Manchester. And more recently, we have these banner headlines saying, I love the NHS. We sign off our greetings card very often with the word love. We also have people who love celebrities from different walks of life, and we have people who love money. In some situations, these become our little idols for whatever reason. When St. Paul was teaching the early Christians, he advised them not to worship false gods, because that's what they can become. He asked them to abandon them, in fact. He teaches them that the love of neighbor is far more important, even the noisy neighbor who keeps you awake all night with loud music, or parks his or her car in a way that obstructs you from using your drive. In fact, St. Paul advised his listeners to love those who are poor by responding to their many needs that they have encountered due to circumstances outside their control. Through loving them, we are making them feel valued, respected, thereby acknowledging that they too are made in the image and likeness of God, who loves each and every one of us. The gospel passage that we have heard teaches us that the greatest commandment is to love God with all our heart, with all our soul, and with all our mind. And the second is like it, to love our neighbour as ourselves. What does that mean in today's modern world, a world that has been controlled by COVID-19? In this context, I would like to remind you of the recent teaching of the document by Pope Francis, who is challenging, in that document, he challenges us to love God's earthly home by caring for it and making it a peaceful place to live in, including all creatures, great and small. The love that Jesus, of course, is speaking about is not just the love we have for our parents, our family, our friends. It includes the family spread across the world and all their needs. The church family has always shown concern for the needs of those who are poor, rejected, and all have not received a welcome, like the homeless, the asylum seekers, and refugees. We have countless Christian heroes who have stood up and spoken out on behalf of those who had no voice to be heard. We need only think of people like Oscar Romero, St. Vincent de Paul, Mother Teresa, Nelson Mandela, John Hume, who gave his life to establish peace in Northern Ireland, and Martin Luther King. We have countless others, like priests and religious and lay people, who gave their lives in serving people across the world. Love, indeed, is about sharing our wealth and talents with those who have nothing, through various agencies like CAFOT and food banks. Love, too, is not abusing but caring for the planet, what Pope Francis calls God's earthly home. And in more recent times, we had two great characters in the Manchester area. One is a footballer, one is the Lord Mayor of Manchester. And Mr. Ratchford has spoken out on behalf of the poor and the needy, because he experienced poverty in his own life, he experienced hunger, he experienced a lack of hospitality, and today he's become a voice of the voiceless, of the poor. And the world has heard him, and of course, what more importantly still, the British government have listened to his appeal as well, and have consented and listened and acted on that appeal, because he was showing love for neighbour. God has also chosen all of us to be stewards of each other through prayer, praying for those who find great difficulty in loving. St. John, in fact, teaches us, God is love, let us love one another. Pope Francis likewise teaches us, in order to save oneself, one has to love God and neighbour. And this is an uncomfortable call. It is actually entering the narrow gate to heaven, because it is exceptionally demanding. Love, therefore, is always demanding something of us. It requires commitment. Indeed, it requires great effort, an effort that is determined and persevering and willing to sacrifice oneself for the love of sake of others, and to live according to the teaching of the gospel that we just heard. In fact, St. Paul calls it a good fight of faith. And then he goes on to say, it takes a daily, all-day effort to love one's neighbour.
The response is, Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For our church community, so that we are able to follow our leaders and gain knowledge on how to follow in Jesus' footsteps, and so that our leaders have the power and patience to guide us, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For our family, so that we can support each other, be kind to one another, and know the value of spending quality time together, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For our school community, so that we are never rude to each other, and that we show kindness and understanding of our differences, may we have courage to try our best and succeed, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For our students, so that we never give up in their pursuits for excellence, that we treat each other the way that we would like to be treated, no matter who they are or where they come from. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For those who are suffering, so that we are able to get help they need and deserve, give them the strength to carry on when times are hard. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We now ask Mary to pray with us
and for us as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
We now reflect on how our form saints inspire us in everyday life.
St. Francis of Assisi teaches us that happiness cannot be found in possessions, but in God alone.
St. Maximilian Kolbe teaches us the importance of putting others before ourselves.
St. Mother Teresa teaches us to reach out to everyone with care and compassion.
St. Margaret Ward teaches us the power of faith in God.
St. Oscar Romero teaches us to speak out when we see injustice.
St. John Paul teaches us to be forgiving towards others.
Let us pray together as Jesus taught us. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
The Lord be with you. This is a special blessing now for the students in year 7 who have entered All Saints Catholic College for the first time. And we're asking for a very special blessing on all your human endeavors. And I hope you felt very welcome as All Saints and feel comfortable with your made new friends. And so the blessing is for all of you. May God bless you as you begin your time here at All Saints Catholic College. May Jesus be your friend to accompany you on your journey. And may the Holy Spirit inspire you all in your activities. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.